again. My name's Gabe Zalna. This is the 31st of January, 2019. Article posted by Fox News, written by Judge Andrew Napolitano of Fox News. Judge Andrew Napolitano, an American nightmare. That's the title. There's an embedded video you might want to sort of gaze at. Last Friday, on a quiet residential street at 6 in the morning, the neighborhood exploded in light, noise, and terror. 17 SUVs and two armed vehicles arrived in front of one house. Each vehicle had sirens blaring and lights flashing. The house, which abutted a canal, was soon surrounded by 29 government agents, each wearing military garb, each carrying a handgun, and most carrying high-powered automatic rifles. In the canal were two amphibious watercrafts, out of which more heavily armed government agents came. Circling above all this was a helicopter equipped with long-range precision weaponry and high-powered spotlights. Four agents approached the front door to the house. Two held a battering ram, and two pointed their rifles at the door. One of the agents shouted and banged on the front door until the terrified owner of the house emerged, barefoot and wearing shorts and a t-shirt. He was greeted in the dark as he opened his front door by two rifle barrels aimed at his head. You'd think that they were coming to get one of the mafia leaders, huh? The drug cartel leaders, but they weren't. This was not a movie set. It was not a foreign city in a war zone. It was not the arrest of a Venezuelan opposition leader in Caracas. It was Middle America, Fort Lauderdale, Florida. The agents worked for the FBI, and the target of this operation was not a drug kingpin or a terrorist operative or a kidnapper of babies. It was a peaceful American in his own home, a political operative and longtime friend of President Donald Trump named Roger Stone. Why were there more FBI agents sent to the arrest Stone than Navy SEALs sent to kill Osama bin Laden? Why jackboots in the morning in America? Here is the backstory. Stone had been both a paid formal advisor and an unpaid informer advisor to Trump for 40 years. He was fired from Trump's presidential campaign during the summer of 2015, but he continued to work on his own to help Trump defeat Hillary Clinton in the 2016 presidential election. Some of that help, according to the government, involved the release of embarrassing Clinton emails that had probably been hacked by Russian agents. See, here's the problem. Involving the release of embarrassing Clinton emails. Here's a presidential candidate that had embarrassing Clinton emails. Are you sort of getting the picture? The whole thing's a complete joke. Last Thursday, one of the special counsel Robert Mueller's grand juries indicted Stone on 5 counts of lying to Congress. They need to indict Robert Mueller for his participation in the takedown of 9/11. They need to indict Robert Mueller for all the countless crimes that he committed when he went ahead and retained a gangster in Boston, Whitey Bulger. Why do you think Whitey got whacked? The day he got transferred to another prison, the day he was in, he just arrived at another prison, he gets whacked. Might that have been to silence him? Stone was represented by counsel throughout the time of his testimony before Congress last year. He was the recipient of a grand jury subpoena for his text messages, his emails, and other records, all of which, through his counsel, he surrendered. He claims that when asked by members of the House Intelligence Committee about certain aspects of these, he innocently forgot about them. Who could remember each of 1 million texts and emails? You know what's amazing is these members of Congress, they can lie their asses off. Like Richard Blumenthal. Yeah, I was in Vietnam. I remember what it was like coming back and how difficult it was the way we were treated. The only Vietnamese restaurant he's ever visited is one he visited. The rest, lies. Is he being held accountable to the American people for lying? Huh? Absolutely not. He's just one of them. They're all full of bullshit. In the real world, where the influence of politics into law enforcement is kept to a harmless minimum, defense counsel generally known to prosecutors throughout their investigations of a target. According to Stone, federal prosecutors have known for a year who his lawyers are. Also, in the real world, when a defendant has been indicted for a nonviolent crime, has no criminal record, and is not a flight risk or an imminent danger to society, prosecutors inform defense counsel of the indictment, send the defense counsel a copy of it, and request the peaceful and dignified surrender of the indicted person. All this is bravado by the whacked out Democrats. That's all it is, bravado. In the current unreal world, where politics deeply infuse law enforcement, prosecutors use brute force to send a message of terror to innocent defendants. Like all defendants at the time of arrest, Stone is innocent until proven guilty beyond a reasonable doubt. What message does brute force send? It is a message of terror and has no place in American life. As if to add embarrassment to terror, the feds may have tipped off CNN, which carried this live in real time. You want to read the rest of the article? Absolutely disgusting. I mean, they had SWAT teams arresting a guy that had no reason to be arrested. Just total bullshit. I can't wait. Well, I said can't wait. The reality is, we have no one to go to. And either does Roger Stone. He too has no one to go to. You can't fight this criminal government. If you've watched some of my recent videos, the CIA is responsible for the countless murder of high-level political figures, including one of our presidents, JFK, including a potential president, his brother, Robert, his son, JFK Jr. The list is endless, and it's all done by our government. You think not? You're damn well not thinking. Problem is, who are you going to go to? There bloody well is no one to go to. Is there? The link will be attached. Read the rest of the article. Pass it along to your like-minded friends. Ask them to do the same. Repost it in all your social media accounts. Thanks for listening. Really pisses me off.